Hello, Ilyan here, and in this video, we're going to take a look at how to run two or more Mesh Central servers simultaneously and load balance the traffic between them. So Mesh Central has an incredible feature of being able to peer multiple Mesh Central servers simultaneously, and you're going to be able to use either one of these servers, and they're in active-active configuration, so both servers, or if you have three, four, five servers, they will all run simultaneously, talk to each other, and load balance and collaborate with each other on the traffic. So let's take a look at how we do that. First, I'm going to present this little slide here and just take a look at what we're about to do. I'm going to have two Mesh Central servers running. They're going to set up a communication channel between each other so they can cooperate. And then we will have agents connecting to the server, and we will have browsers connecting to the server. And obviously, if a user is on server number two and an agent is connected on server number one, well, if you do a remote desktop session, the remote session has to go through server number two, then server number one, and to the agent. Same for the other side. If you have a remote desktop session initiated on server one, but a device is on server two, you want to be able to have the two servers collaborate so that the communication channels flow correctly. Now, once you have this set up, you can do interesting things. Like, for example, you can have a load balancer in front of your two servers. And so when browsers or agents connect, you will split the traffic between the two servers. Or you can have what I call a multi-geo setup, where you actually have two independent IP addresses or different names. Of course, those two servers will have to have the same rules, the same database, and communicate. But you can have, you know, a batch of devices connected to one IP in a geo and a different IP on a different geo or something like that. So that is the options you have. Now, obviously, I just stated that both servers will need to use the same MongoDB database. You have no choice. You will have to use MongoDB for server peering support. And the MongoDB database must have replica set turned on and change stream turned on. So let's take a look at what that looks like. I'm going to start here with my trusty developer server. This is the same one we've seen in many videos before, and it runs a single instance. Now, what I'm going to do is run two instances of Mesh Central on my developer machine. So I'm not going to have two different computers in this case. I'm going to have a single computer running two different servers. And so this is how I debug Mesh Central normally. So let's take a look at the configuration. Normally, you would have a single config.json file. Here, I'm going to have two. I'm going to create two files, config.p1 and config.p2.json. And it's the same configuration as, you know, same file that you would normally have, except that the first of all, I'm using MongoDB with the replica set. So you will need to install MongoDB and turn that feature on. And you will also need to turn on the change stream on MongoDB. So make sure you have that all set up. And you can try that on a, you know, while you have a single instance of the server to make sure that all this works correctly. Now, once you have that, the other thing is I'm going to have, between the two configuration, the server number one is going to use the normal ports. So 443.80, 443.33 for the MPS AMT port. So that's some of the normal ports. But for the second server, because I'm going to run it on the same machine, in this case, I'm going to add one to each port. So 444.81, 443.1. Okay. Then server number one and server number two, we're going to have the peers section. And here, you're going to have to specify what the server ID is for, in this case, it's central one for my server number one. And for server number two, it's going to be central two. And then you have to specify the, for each of the servers, what connection URI, the connection URI to the other server. So in this case, server one, it will talk to server two using this URI, and this is a WebSocket or secure WebSocket URI. So WSS instead of HTTPS, it's WebSocket. So you just put WS, and then the internal IP address and port of the other server. So the other server happens to be on 444, so that's what I'm going to use here. And then the second one, it's going to have the same configuration, central one, central two, with the same URIs. But of course, the ID will be central number two. Now, if you don't specify the ID, by default, the host name of the machine is going to be used as the ID. So what you could do is have the same config.json on all your peers, but you just specify the host name for host name one, host name two, and so on, and then the ID will be the host name of that specific machine. And the way it works is, if you have three, four, five servers all running together, what they do is they compare their identifiers, and I think it's like the identifier that's bigger than the other one will connect to that one or something like that. So you end up having one server connecting to the other ones, and there's some servers that are just going to receive connections. So that's how the mesh of connections between the servers will be built. Okay, so once you have that, you basically save these two files in Mesh Central Data. I'm going to close this. I'm going to stop my server that's running in single instance mode, and then I'm going to run it Node Mesh Central. This is a developer machine, so normally you would do node module / Mesh Central, and I'm going to specify a config file, and I'm going to specify config p1 in this case because I'm going to run server number one. So up we go. Server number one is now running. And then if I hit refresh on the browser, I have it running here. And everything looks perfectly normal. Also, it just so happens that all my computers here, all the Raspberry Pis and other computers that I have on the network, they're all going to connect to 443. So they're all going to connect to server number one. So that's what we see right here. Okay. And of course, because I didn't specify a port in the URI, this browser is also connected on server number one, which is normal. I didn't start server number two yet. So, okay, now what I'm going to do is open another box here, and I am going to run Node Mesh Central config file and config p2. So this will run a second Mesh Central, but using the second config file. So I'm going to go ahead and run that. And up you go, we have a second server running. So we have now both running at the same time. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to connect to port 444. And I am going to receive a web page on this browser, but the web page is now coming from server number two. Now, what's nice is even though the server number two served me this web page, and I'm talking to server number two, I'm seeing all the devices, including all the devices that were connected on server number one. So I can click on a device, see all the state, hit connect, and remote desktop works. Now here, remote desktop is going from my browser to server number two, to one, then to the target, because of course, the agent is connected on server number one. Another thing that's interesting, I'm going to open a second browser, and this one, I want to connect on server number one. So I'm going to basically remove this. Okay. So the browser on the left is server number one. Browser on the right, server number two. I can just put online here. So another thing that's nice is that I can click on a device like AMT15, and you see it here. And I can change the icon. And you can see that the icons match correctly. That's because both servers are talking to each other. They're actually saving the new state of this machine into the database, and the database is eventing to both servers that the icon has changed, and that's being reflected on the UI. Same for the mesh name, the device name. I can change it. You see the names change, and so on. So even though we're running on two separate servers, they're coordinating correctly. Now, what happens if I shut down one of the servers? Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut down server one, which is the server that all the agents are on. And let's take a look at what happens here. Control C, boom. So now what happens is that server number one is out of commission. Oops, have to shake the mouse here. Server number one is out of commission, but you can see server number two, it now still shows all the devices, but they're pretty much all offline. Now the exception is all the AMT devices, and that's because I'm currently in hybrid mode right there. And so because I'm in hybrid mode, what's going on is that, you know, this server is still tracking those AMT devices. But otherwise, all these devices would be offline if I didn't have to, if I was in WAN mode, all the devices would be offline. Now I'm gonna start this first server again. And as I start this first server, the agents are going to start connecting to server number one, and then server number one and two are going to start reconnecting together, and then we'll see that the state will resynchronize on the web page. So of course, the browser has not lost contact with server number two, but now you see the devices start popping up again. So you see it here and here as they connect back. And then of course I can click and immediately connect, and I see the terminal, and terminal works, and so on. Well, that's pretty wild. And of course, I got server number one came back on this web page. So actually that's pretty easy. One thing to note is that another thing that's funny is on the my servers page, one of the issues here is that in general, this will show only the statistics for the server you're connected on, except for the stat page. Actually, the stats page, I don't have it right now, but if you wait a long enough time, you'll start seeing data on both servers in the stat page, and you'll be able to select which server you want to take a look. So you'll have a little drag down box here with server number one or server number two, but you need to have the server running for enough time that you start having data show up. But otherwise, if you do console, if you do trace, if you look at the general here, you will only be affecting the server you're connected on. So for example, if I do an update, of course that will only update the server I'm connected to. One question that I sometimes get is it important that both servers be exactly the same version of Mesh Central? And the answer is kind of ish yes. Obviously, if you're running a version of Mesh Central on server one that is different version than the other one, there may be some features that, you know, one server have that the other doesn't, and they won't coordinate that great. But it should roughly work correctly. So I hope this was a good demonstration. It's fairly easy. Once you get the database set up and you get the config files up and running, this is a fairly easy setup to accomplish. And so in general, I think you guys should be, about half an hour, should have all this set up and working correctly. Hopefully this was helpful. Thank you very much. Have a great day.